Hi everyone. So in this video, we will take a look on example like how we can use Dockerfile with Node.js application to run the container. Okay. So we'll just try to launch the Node.js application with the Dockerfile. So what we can do is we can have a look into this code. Okay. So this is our Node.js code having simple Express CLI generated code. Nothing much. Okay. Basic Node.js application. Now, if you try to use Docker, what you need to use, what you need to have a Docker file. Because Docker file will help us to create this Node.js container, and at the runtime of this Docker file will become image to a container, and that container will have a Node.js runtime running, like HTTP server running on a particular port in that particular container, and you will be exposing a port so that the host system will talk to the Node.js container. Okay, so in this Docker file which we have seen in the previous video, we just put a basic instructions like node carbon working directory, copying all the code to the working directory. Okay, src we can put for now. Okay, cdsrc, I think we don't need it. So let me try this. So what we can do is from this Docker file we can actually try to build it. So what we need to do is docker build. You can say my node.js, and from the current working directory we are building this. So it is built and it is actually pulling the node carbon image, and you can see this is the layers of this particular Docker file. Okay, you can see docker images, try to minimize it. So my node.js, you can see this is the image ID and this is created. I think this is the same name we have provided, my node.js. Now you can run this particular image using docker run image name, right? But we will not be able to access the resources from that container. This container is exposing 3000 ports. So what we can do is docker run this image ID. Okay, we also need to do the port mapping like -p. So what I'm saying is 3001 port of host will map to the 3000 of the container port, right? And I'm passing the image ID of this. This is fine. So now I can see my Node.js is running on port 3001. And let's see what all routes we have in this application. We can try to run on 3001. You can see we are able to see this welcome page, right? Because this is coming from container. Container is, we have already done the mapping of host with container. 3000 port of host is mapped to the 3001 is mapped to 3000. So we can do the, we can access 3000 port from host. Okay. And this is running the basic Node.js application there. Okay, so this is the basic example. What we did is we just created a Docker file, wrote basic instruction inside it, and we just build this Docker file so we get the image, and then we run that image to get the container. Okay, so this is how it is working. Now, next set of videos, what I'm doing is I'm merging my another playlist, which is already talking about Docker Compose and advanced thing about Docker, like how you can have a multi-container setup where you are running a MongoDB, MySQL and all for a local development setup. In local development, you will be using Node.js MySQL or Node.js with MongoDB, Node.js with Redis MongoDB. So you can have one Docker Compose file and you can have all these things combined. You will talk about Docker Compose. So you need to have a Docker Compose.yml file. Okay. And when you do Docker Compose up, you are able to spin up all the containers in a one go in a single network, so they can also talk to one another. So for those, I will be adding a new set of videos in the same playlist. So guys, if you like this kind of tutorial setup, please like, share, subscribe my channel. I'm not putting any lot of kind of advertisement. I'm putting the good quality content, whatever I can achieve. I'm sharing the GitHub link and creating the playlist and sharing this link everywhere. Okay, thanks everyone. Bye bye.